Last couple we had, some people want to know your opinion on AIM still, and it's been like a while since AIM even had that big issue. So that I can't even tell you how many came in.
American Indian Movement?
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. There you go.
I don't know what even happened with that. I actually watched a couple of their videos before they had the Q PSYOP thing going on, but you know, I saw that one video and they're like, we have this consortium of like people that we get information from, and Q is a puzzle and Q has contacted us, and now we're the new Q
or
something.
Q,
like,
yes.
I don't even know what's going on there, but anytime I hear that kind of thing, that's like a red flag for me. So, you know, we haven't had any interaction with them. You know, I heard some phone call with this gentleman. I think he goes by Thomas Paine with American Intelligence Media, not to be confused with the Thomas Paine of True Pundit. He was on like a phone call with Jason Goodman and like yelling at him and cursing. And I was like, that what was the weird. Heck is going on? This is weird. So I don't really know anything about it other than I saw a couple of videos I thought were bizarre.
Yeah, actually, the comment I copied brought that exact thing up. I just didn't add it in, so I'm glad you said that, because that'll at least answer someone's, you know, question they sent me. So, let me see here. Oh, okay. And I wanted to apologize myself. I know that when we had a Q, I call people Q-tubers if they only cover Q, and there was a woman that sent me the weirdest group of emails I'd ever read, and I know I made an assumption, and I want to apologize to both of you. I mean, I did try my best to say every time I said, well, it does seem they're talking about CBTS chat, and I only said that because it said CBTS above it and then chat lower be down, but a few times when I brought it up, I didn't give my disclaimer, and I do want to apologize for not doing that. But people want to know if you have opinion on any of the emails that were leaked. I know that you said that that was not your email and it didn't have anything to do with you. So, and I completely believe you.
You're talking about the Corsi thing with the
A858 email. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. I don't know anybody from our generation that uses a freaking AOL email. I got to say,
that's what I said too, man.
So weird to me. Yeah.
And you know,
definitely not.
Those emails got sent to her, the explanation was that they just appeared in her inbox. So there's a lot of questions to be asked there.
Do you happen to have them on you? I'm curious what Corsi's listed email is.
I can send them to you, but let me see if I can pull them up real fast. I've got my email up. I just got
to I can compare that with the email addresses we have for Dr. Corsi. I didn't think to check this last time they came up. I don't know if the person is maybe posing as Corsi or if his email actually did get hacked.
I wondered that too. Now, I was assured by the sender that it was Corsi's email, but then again, I couldn't confirm it. I tried, I just couldn't. So,
and even if it is, it's like it's still a list of, you know, just text.
It was a very weird conversation. It wasn't anything that outed anything or said anything weird. It was just a very strange conversation. So, I'll send you the whole thing later on. I'll put it in Discord for you so you've got a copy, because I've got a link into a pub thing that has the whole thing. So I'll bring that up later.
Light Switch says, "What is AOL?"
Oh, we're getting old, man.
I know. It's weird, man. You remember getting those in the mail, the little AOL mailer packets?
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. That's all I wanted to bring up. I don't know if anyone out there wants to bring up anything else or anything. I don't want to just jump out, you know, without giving the other people here a chance to say anything.
If I could, I noticed in chat they were mentioning that back on Unirock's channel that a lot of people in his chat were upset, saying this was staged.
Not at all.
Wait, what was staged? This is the same.
Because we're getting along so well, I guess. Really?
No.
No, I mean,
I don't know what to expect, but I think it's going to go.
This is just how patriots act.
I told everybody from the beginning that anytime I speak to anybody, even if it's somebody I'm having an issue with, because I've had YouTube channels, not you guys, but I've had YouTube channels where that have, you know, insulted me or trolled me or just straight out, you know, said that I work for, you know, the FBI or something. I always try to have a regular conversation. I don't ever scream, yell, throw fits. So if they expected anything different, then they shouldn't have expected that. That's for sure.
Yeah, I think that's silly.
I wanted to ask you.
We've got trolls right now anyway, too. But go ahead, dude. Sorry, didn't mean to
come. I'm hearing that, yeah.
No worries. I just wanted to ask you about this whole DeFango thing. If I understand it right, he implied there's a connection between AIM, Cicada, and the CIA, and then was banned on Twitter. Is that how it went?
Yeah, so I just had DeFango, me and DeFango play PUBG, or play a military sim game every night. Usually through the week, it's at least three nights out of the week he'll jump into my game. So we were talking last night, and he explained that whole thing about him outing. Now, this is DeFango's claim, of course. You know, I always want evidences or something before I fully believe anything, so that's just a disclaimer, but he says, from what I understood, there was an outing between a connection from AIM to Cicada. That's how I took it. And then, yeah, his Twitter, which he had a really giant Twitter. It was like, mine might be 1,000 people. I know he had at least 20,000 or so, maybe more, but it just disappeared all of a sudden right before I came online today. So it's really strange. Yeah, I don't know what else to say, but it's really strange. I'm looking into that tonight myself.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw DeFango put out a video about like the DeFango or the Cicada group. That he put out like a 4-hour video about he thought he had been like fooled by these people. So I didn't get a full chance to watch all 4 hours of it. But
so wait, is he saying that when you say there's a connection between the CIA, Cicada, and what was the third one?
American intelligence media.
Yeah, so saying like they are CIA, AIM, and Cicada are CIA, because it's at least been my opinion that Cicada is somehow tied to the CIA that way. Is that what's being said?
If there's one person that would know, it would be DeFango, at least when it comes to Cicada. Yeah. Now, I'm not saying that he would know anything about AIM. I don't know anything about his ties there, but for a very long time, he's proven that he can solve really complex internet puzzles. I've watched him. That, in my opinion, will lead me to be at least accepting of the fact that he probably does know some stuff about Cicada. But all of it is, conjecture at this point. You should get DeFango in here because, man, it's a crazy story and it's definitely worth looking into. Maybe not in the fact that people, they try to say it's connected to Q and Cicada are connected, and I don't necessarily have any opinion there, but he'll definitely fill you in.
Have you heard of the Mayday Mysteries? Mayday Mystery.
What's the website?
No.
If you want something to dig through on your channel,
my gosh.
People probably love it.
Well, it's like the this is like the old school version of Cicada. This was the Mayday Mysteries, I think. .org. Maydaymystery.org. These were like historical mystery and logic puzzles that were published in the Arizona Daily Wildcat going back to like the 70s. And some of them are just bizarre. But I saw that and that was like, to me, just reminded me of Cicada, like the precursor to it. You got to look into the Mayday Mystery, though.
Yeah, I'm always looking. That's my thing. I started on YouTube just looking at mysteries and trying to separate
I love that.
Yeah, that's my favorite thing. Unsolved Mysteries was my favorite show when I was young.
Me too.
You know what I'm saying?
I loved Robert Stack's voice as a kid.
Doing a screen share right now. I don't know if you can see it, but this is the kind of thing.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it just popped up.
Really bizarre.
These are the Mayday.
Oh, that's Mayday Mysteries. That's that. Yeah. Oh, okay. Wow. Okay.
Bizarre. It's something
really complex and bizarre. It's just strange.
It's like a puzzle kind of thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
James Munder was on here like a while ago, and we were going over this one night, and it was bizarre. This stuff goes back, I think, to the 70s. These were full page ads that were taken out in the Arizona Daily Wildcat, and they're very cryptic and weird, but they're like puzzles. There's all kinds of them, and this one's from 1981. And they're just bizarre. And then this gentleman made a website about it, and he's still getting contacted by these people. It's really weird, though. And they're still publishing the ads and stuff. And I'm like, I just look at it and I go, wow, that reminds me of like the whole Cicada puzzle thing. So who knows?
Yeah, they're still published every year on May 1st, Mayday, which is weird. Commie connections and stuff. One thing I wanted to mention.
Crucian symbolism and all this and Lutheranism. It's just weird.
It's really weird stuff.
It's very interesting, though.
There we go.
Yeah.